dough. Ride around in that boat, I got the shift on the flow. You don't know where these niggas mindset when they plot on the dough. So I ride around next to burner, extra clips in the dough. Getting paranoid in the day, people might kick in the dough. But when you paper chase, you chase that paper far as to go. Cause I'd rather be tired from hustling.
What it is and what the fuck it is and what it ain't gonna be, you dig? Shouts out to all those who do what the fuck they do. Much praise and much honor and respect and glory go to the creator. For all things beauty. For all things period. Without it, there could be no us, so let's first be mindful as we partake and get into the atmosphere. Geeked up with one's motherfucking feet up, indeed and intrigued. It be about Sauce, Captain Kush, Nature Boy, himself live and on location. Beachfront property, Jupiter, Seven Moon, overseeing shit. You know, like, we be doing a time stamp. It's my youngest son's birthday yesterday. My oldest son, my bad, Taji. Shouts out to your boy. Love you to death, man. Shouts out. Anybody just going through transgression, going through animosity, going through trauma, going through bickering, going through fighting, going through adversity, trying times. Shit just ain't sitting the way you want it to sit. I feel you, boy. I feel you more than you know, boy. I done walked down them corridors and them hallways of injustice time and time again, boy. You couldn't tell me a king ain't supposed to be here. I knew a king wasn't supposed to be here. Believe that. I'm gonna get into it. I'm trying to sweat out this little situation with me, so don't mind me. Give me a minute. I'm gonna let this geek get all the way up on me. Let this rolling rock get up all the way on me. Shouts out to the Rolling Rock. The boy Toby put me on these back in like, shit, 99? Maybe before that, 10th grade year. I get into the subject of what a music tape. That pussy know me better than I know myself. I don't know about that. I know me more than that bitch know me. I know me before you knew me. I ain't saying you ain't a wonderful, beautiful individual. All I'm trying to say is, if you gave me my preference, if you asking me my real preference, it's gonna take. It's gonna take more than you to get it going. Let's take sex out of the equation. Let's take kissing, hugging, fondling, teasing, sucking on this, grabbing on that, staring each other, googly eyes, pussy up on the table. Let's take all that shit off the wall. I'm just talking about your sense of humor. You don't want me to call you bitch. You feel a way when I call you a funky cock hoe. You know what I mean? You perturbed behind shit like that. You vexed at why I would do such a thing. Just a play of words, man. I be fucking around and bullshitting with the foo-foo. You know what I mean? Sometimes I do what the fuck I be doing. But personality-wise, certain shit I can't go with. So, excuse me, I gotta drop down where I'm at just off of personality. That ain't got shit to do with me not loving you. That ain't got shit to do with me not caring about you, because I know I can have a conversation about some shit. You just ain't finna entertain, don't want to be down with, and probably gonna start a problem. I could do this over here, and it's all gonna be good. Just off that alone. Let's say sports. Let's say video game. Let's just say outdoorsy workout shit. That may not be your thing. But what can I do about that? See, my thing is, I accept you for what you are. Whatever 4 foot you put, I'ma take it what it is. I can motivate on it so far. The person gotta want it themselves. Any intervention gotta tell you that. They don't want it for themselves. That ain't in them. They gonna feel like whatever they start doing with you, and because you know, came up with it, they might have some resentment and animosity towards you. Cause it ain't in their true heart of mind. They move that direction. You don't bring it out of them. They don't bring it out of themselves. I ain't into forcing shit. But if I know your limitations ain't gonna get discarded just because you cute and shit. Like, remember, if you play 2K, Madden, all that shit, create a player. That nigga be 50 down the middle, and you gotta get a nigga there. Your bitch sitting on the low standard, and you recognize it, she recognize it. She take it further and don't just recognize it. She shout it at you and tell you this is what she all about. And she mock you with the fact that other niggas want it. Other niggas want that pussy, but I don't know if they willing to deal with all this fuck shit. You know what I mean? You could trick a good nigga into caring about this pussy, but even he'll find out you a selfish son of a gun, you know what I mean? Shouts out. I don't try to make something what it ain't, you feel me? It is what the fuck it is most days out the week with me on most things. You know what I mean? I recognize something and it's understood. I ain't gotta make no apologies or have no meetings and come to no session and hearing about my decision to seek other sources. Means of getting what I need. It's not your job to give me what I need. Not your job to feel any way about me being happy either. Being happy without you is a cause and disease that's hurt many people. They call it jealousy and all the other shit. It's just simply this. A person's lack. Don't give a fuck about that other person. The most selfish about their own feelings, that they not the one making you totally happy, projects them to, you know, feeling all these self-doubt, you know, low self-esteem moments. And that shit turns into the term misery loves company, right? What they say? So, because they can't make you happy completely, they don't want nothing to make you happy. It's confusing. I remember not eating pussy. I tell a woman in a heartbeat, go ahead and do your thing. I ain't saying I can rock with you the same way. I'm not finna be in an uproar about some shit you wanna do. You wanna do it? Ain't nobody forcing you. You ain't just trying to get back. Low down. This some shit you been, you know what I mean? That's what a nigga do. That's what a player bitch do. She wanna fuck this nigga, get this nigga some pussy, man. She riding with it. She okay with her decision. These bitches be acting like, oh, I only fucked him because I wasn't with you. Bitch, you might as well sell pussy then, cause that's a piss poor ass excuse to be giving a nigga some pussy, man. You know how much that nigga care about you? It's probably a lot lower than the lowest your ass thought. I'm just saying. That's the nigga you banking on and done gave a nigga some pussy, done let in your house, meet your children. That nigga don't give a fuck about you at all. He fucking seven hoes. But got you convinced it might be going somewhere because he believe in the same shit you believe in for the most part. That's what he tell you. Because he always set you up with, tell me about yourself. You know, where you see yourself in 10 years, you know. I don't ask a bitch none. Yeah, I might not know this bitch after this meeting, or 10 minutes later, this bitch do something I don't like. I might be out the door on this hoe, man. Ain't got time for this shit. Ain't got time for playing. Like, bitch, you cool as you ain't. You show me crazy off the jump. I gotta get the fuck. This ain't the sit around show on shit like that, chap. Gotta goddamn take hold and say, I know my goddamn limitations here now. I have what they call shit to prove in this situation. So I ain't finna get out of line. Getting out of line. So my problem, like being stand-up niggas in the world, is dominated by herd and cattle type motherfuckers, you know, the majority. A nigga who stand out. It's my fault for not checking every situation and feel what the consequences are. Me and God gotta live with the shit we do. I call myself being smart and trying to avoid shit, but you can't avoid. Can't avoid the inevitable. What's gonna be is what's gonna be, right? Word, say word. Speak on a little bit more. Keep it simple. As a child, I love the genre of cartoon. From He-Man to Silverhawks to Thunder Motherfucking Cats. You feel me? They were all cartoons. They were all same kind of the premise, you know, good and evil type shit. But it was a variety. It was unique differences of why I fucked with each one. Cereal, I fuck with Cinnamon Toast Crunch, Fruity Pebbles, Apple Jacks, top three. You know what I mean? Growing up. Now. The point of this is variety. It's always been a spice of life. We wouldn't have made so much abundance of shit if we wasn't supposed to partake. We partake in all type of foods, drinks, TV shows, you know what I mean, clothes, but then we get to a person, especially in a metropolis city, and you like, hey, calm down. I know your variety is out the roof, but you need to be disciplined. Why? For what? When I seen the Flavor Love and the Bachelor and all this shit, I was like, yeah, I see where you going with it. That's how I feel like it should go, nigga. Y'all gotta jump and choose a nigga. Problem is, financially, I haven't been put in a situation to put myself in a situation at this point where it's like, oh, okay, you know, I can secure life and shit for you with money outside of the nigga that I am. So motherfuckers don't look at me as a catch, but fine, better overall. Give me the same dollar amount. Give me the same connections of this nigga you talking about and watch me do it. That's all. Just watch me do it. Shake a booty, bitch. I'm gone.